My name is Jessica Davies.
And I'm Darla Seigel.
This is our presentation for accounting 275 of Treasure Island Books. This is the business concept that we came up with for our proposal. We are a family-friendly bookstore. We're going to be located on Daniel Island. We want to share the joy of reading a real book, not just an electronic book or watching movies. I mean, kids get so wrapped up in social media and everything that's online that they don't sit down and take the time to just read a book, enjoy it with their families. Their families are so disconnected these days. They're always off doing something else on Facebook or Instagram or any other kind of social media that they don't sit down and just read. I mean, kids are actually lacking a lot of reading skills in today's society because that's not what they're focused on. That's not what they do. But what we want to do is bring that joy and share it with the community back into the home, back into everyone's lives, and enjoy a frozen smoothie while you do it. We want everyone to come in and enjoy the atmosphere. We have something for everyone. We're going to be locally owned and operated, which is a big plus, so that people don't feel like they're ignored or it's just a commercial thing that they have no connection to.
And Jessica and I both share the love of books, and we want to just bring that to the community. And we are co-owners of a limited liability partnership. Our shares are 50-50, and we have many years of retail experience, and we're well-informed in management skills and functions. We have many years of experience in inventory and accounting, as well as food service for our smoothie bar. We both enjoy that. And we brought on two part-time employees, and hopefully in the future we can add on as business builds, but that's where we're at right now.
For financing, we're gonna start out with a small business loan of $100,000 to get started with our inventory, which is gonna be starting from nothing, more expansive than a lot of places would be. Also for the furniture and the bookshelves and all of the other stuff that's gonna be incorporated. We're also going to have an open line of credit, $25,000, for any of the eventualities that may crop up and to help us, say, taxes or anything that we may need. And as partners, we're both contributing an opening contribution of $5,000.
Most of the financing up front went to purchasing all the equipment we needed. The smoothie machine or the slushy machine, we have one, and in the future we're hoping to build on that. Put another one in there and maybe some other things. We're looking into that. Smoothie supplies were purchased along with bookshelves. There were two computers purchased, one for the office use and one for the counter.
With Quicken software for POS.
That's correct. And office furniture, which was a two desks and some office chairs. And then the table and chairs for the smoothie bars were purchased. At the start, and of course the largest purchase was for our book inventory.
Daniel Island is a small pedestrian town where everyone is there. They are pretty much, they try to be self-contained. They want to have everything on the island so that if you don't want to leave the island, you don't have to. Has three schools, there are 4,000 homes on the island. But there's always something unique. It's a local, they want local. They don't want the big corporate commercial businesses. They want something that's unique, something that's friendly, that somebody feels like they can ride their bike to and just have a smoothie and grab a book, or just to have fun, meet friends, to do stuff like that. So I think it would be a perfect location for us to start our family-owned friendly business.
The target market is the white-collar professional and the families that live on the island. The average income for the island is $127,000 per year. And the average household expenditure for this is $86,000. And the demographics show the consumer spending is consistently above the national average. And in 2015, the community within a five-mile radius spent $1,400,000 on books and periodicals. So there is definitely a market here.
Yeah.
And they like to spend money, and we like that.
This is a picture of the location at 211 River Landing Drive. It is located out by Simmons Park, which
The retail space is street level, and there's 269 luxury apartment units above, which is awesome for having foot traffic. People in the morning can stop by and get a smoothie on their way out the door to work, or they can stop in at lunch. The location is excellent for foot traffic. It's in the center intersection of 7 Farmers Drive, which is the main strip of town, and on the corner of River Landing Drive. And it's within walking distance of all the other shops in the area. That's where all the retail hub is right within that walking distance.
And the space that we're going to have is 2,200 feet, so it's not too large to call it a small family-owned bookstore, but it's not too small where people are going to be feeling crowded and jostled and like they can't go in and enjoy themselves and just browse. Our competition is, closest one is 7.6 miles away, Mount Pleasant, which has a tremendous amount of traffic. There is constantly traffic going to and from. Mount Pleasant has become one of the most popular places to go for shopping, for eating, for living. It's more upscale. So we wouldn't have that much competition versus if people wanted to stay family and close to home and friendly. Daniel Island is a great place to go out with your family and bike and to travel and just wander around and see whatever you can see in the stores, and going for a smoothie would be a perfect opportunity, you know, for a family that's out enjoying their ride and it's hot, but also they can come in and browse the books. So as a bookstore, there is no competition on the island right now.
Our goals, looking ahead for 2018, we're banking on 20% increase, and we're also looking forward to 2019, hope to do a minimum of 20%, maybe better. We're focused on building the cash revenue for the slowdown times, so we have that extra cash to get us through the tough times. And in December, we'll have the results from our customer survey, and we're really gonna sit down and brainstorm and see what the customer's wanting and what we're missing and build on that. And then we're also working on implementing a customer rewards program, which I think will help us in retail.
We're also, you know, going to do events, try to get the community in there doing, you know, a Halloween celebration and doing something for the different holidays, back to school. Because we want to have reference books and we want to have stuff that, you know, it's not going to be like school supplies, but, you know, if a student needs something for a research project or a book report or something like that, we want to try to be able to accommodate that as well. And then, with, like you said, with the customer surveys, expand upon what we do and what we have to grow in the community, become an integral part of it, so that that's what people want. That's what they want to come there. They want.
Right. And that is a big goal, is to work closely with our community and the schools and see how we can work together to build the business and just be part of that community.
Mm-hmm. As for our future revenues, we plan to try to be, you know, for 2018 above $150,000 and increase in that. I mean, we want our revenues to stay about the same as much as they can. And there's always incidental and things that will crop up. But we want to try to keep it as level as we can. But for our profit, again, we want to try to grow it. So we're going to try to accommodate the community and get them in there and spending the money and wanting to come back and word of mouth and spread it. I mean, even to people that's off the island, it would be not a bad thing for people to want to come and check out our bookstore, even if they don't live on the island, because they've heard so many good things about it.
So, are there any questions?
Some of your competition have programs that allow for book swaps or buybacks. Is this something you plan on utilizing?
We would like to look into incorporating that idea into our store. Some of our favorite places, Mr. K's, that's a fun place to go where you can find new books and swap them out if you found a book that you thought you might like but you didn't really, or you just want to swap it and get a new book, or have them buy We would have to get a feel for the community and see how that idea would be taken, if it would be something that the community would be interested in. If not, then we would not incorporate the idea. But if it was, it wouldn't be a bad idea.
And what are your plans for marketing and advertising?
To start out, the low-end route was to put flyers in all the local businesses, because they do that a lot there. Local businesses support each other and allow for flyers to be posted on their boards or in their windows. So we're going to start out with that. Daniel Island News has I think it's a monthly issue of new businesses coming out, and I've already we've already signed up for that before our grand opening, and they'll do a story on what we're doing and all the details here that we've just covered. And they also plan on advertising specials or special events that come out, and they distribute about 8,000 to businesses and families on the island, so I think we'll be covered.
Yeah, and using the social media as much as we want to try to get some of the attention away from it. There's no better way to get the attention of people and kids is to use social media as well.
And of course, word of mouth is always
that's totally our best, right? Yeah. So
any further questions?
No further questions.
Thank you, sir.
That concludes our presentation, and we hope you enjoy it.